people at UW-Madison research fungi.
Fungi are really important in medicine, food, and the environment.
Some fungi help plants grow, while others destroy crops. Fungi are used to make food and medicine, but they can also cause disease in animals and humans. Fungi also play a key role in the cycling of nutrients in the environment.
The Pringle team studies various aspects of fungi. All of our research is related to evolution, how species change over generations, and ecology, how organisms interact with each other and their environment.
Hi, I'm Naamon. I'm an undergraduate researcher in the Pringle lab, and I study what kinds of fungi can be found on UW-Madison campus, their ecological roles, and their historical uses in society.
I'm Hannah. I'm an undergraduate researcher in the Pringle lab. I study how decomposer fungi adapt to nitrogen pollution, which is caused by human behavior, like the burning of fossil fuels and fertilizers. I knew I wanted to study fungi in college because even though they represent a whole kingdom of life, and they're everywhere in our culture, from video games to fairy tales, they're not often studied in biology class.
I knew I wanted to study fungi in college when I read this book. It just surprised me how many mushrooms and other fungi you could find in the world. And as I learned more about this and I went and collected mushrooms around where I used to live, I just knew this is what I wanted to do.
Being an undergraduate researcher in the Pringle Lab has been a great way to channel our natural curiosity, connect to other people who love science, and contribute to existing knowledge by finding new questions to ask. In this video, we hope to give you a sense of what it's like to research fungi as an undergraduate student.
Along with my research on fungi that grow on campus, I am responsible for creating a field guide to a small selection of the fungi that I've found. A field guide is a book or manual that helps you identify organisms and things like rock types in nature. Field guides are important because they can help you distinguish between things in nature that may look similar or help you figure out where to find certain organisms in a natural environment. I recorded data on the height of the fungi, its cap type, width and color, its gill type, what it was growing on, the time of year, and the weather conditions.
Here are the tools we use to identify fungi in the lab. Researchers identify fungal species by looking at their spores under our microscopes. Much like the data Naamon collected, this is a way to classify fungi based on what they look like. Scientists also rely on molecular techniques like DNA sequencing to classify fungi. DNA is the genetic material that distinguishes one species from another. This process requires multiple steps.
First, researchers isolate the DNA from a sample. Then, they make lots of copies of the DNA using a PCR or polymerase chain reaction machine. Next, they use a technique called gel electrophoresis to apply an electrical current to the DNA, which separates the DNA into fragments. Finally, an automatic sequencing machine identifies the genetic code of the sample.
Being a student researcher has been really rewarding. With the help of great mentors, we've learned how to collect data and study fungi using lab techniques.
Being an undergraduate researcher at UW-Madison has given us a deeper look into what it means to do research. It has allowed us to explore our passions, and we encourage you to come investigate your interests here with us.
Thanks for watching!